The guy I could have been was, you know, complacent or happy that he got something, right? But I wanted to take it by the neck and take it to the next level. I'm Gary Vaynerchuk, and I'm director of operations and co-owner of Wine Library and host of Wine Library TV. We're an over $50 million a year business. We have over 100 employees. We're one of the most visited wine websites on the internet. We are kicking butt a little bit. I've always dreamed crazy big. I fundamentally knew that the competition out there was not ready for what I was going to bring to the table.
All right, buddy, tonight we're talking about going big time.
Sure.
Everybody says, oh, I want to be big, but there are certain things you got to do that you did, some very specific steps that we're going to share tonight. And the first one to go from, in your case, 2 to 50 million, because people are going to say, oh, 2 million, it's okay, is you got to find the hoopla factor, you say. Talk to me about the hoopla factor.
You know, you have to be excited about what you're doing. And so if you have the hoopla factor, it's because you love what you do. And so for me, it's be who you are, be as transparent and as real as possible. And that's gonna make you different because everybody's different. And so whether it's in a personal brand or within your store or whatever you're doing,
What did you do? Okay, here's the difference between staying small and going big. What was your hoopla factor that got you big?
The first small hoopla factor was launching a website. In 1997, winelibrary.com was launched. Nobody was doing that in the wine retail business. The second thing was I was a little bit of a freak show. I was a 17, you know, I was a 20-year-old kid that looked 13 and knew a lot about Burgundy. You know, people came just to see that. But more importantly, I invested very heavily in a different product mix that everybody was really worried about, Bordeaux and California, and I saw Spain and Australia coming on, and so I would pump that and get people excited about that.
So you gotta do it differently. There's gotta be some, if you wanna go big in anything you're doing in life, you gotta say, I wanna do a little, there's gotta be some hoopla in there. The other thing, the next thing you talk about is, you gotta get ahead of the pulse.
Yeah, I mean, reading trends is Death City USA.
Say that again.
Reading trends is Death City USA. You need to be aware of trends and find them. And the way you do that is you get in the pulse. You get into the trenches. I would conversate with every customer that walked through the store. I answer and read every email I get every day, and it's 1,000+ a day. But what that gives me is a crazy R&D. I'm a research and development guy in my own guts. I know what's going on. I know what's coming next. I know Portugal's coming on the scene. I know Greek wines are gonna mean something. And the way I do that is by working my face off and not reading what's coming.
But along those lines also, go in the opposite direction. In your case, everybody was on to California, you said, I'm gonna do Australian wines.
Because I saw that people were liking California wine because they were fruitier and bigger than Bordeaux. Well, where was the next fruity, bigger version of California? It was Australia and Spain. And so it became a very obvious segue in palates. And I just knew that once they got exposure, you know, the wine industry, you know, ratings are very important. And to me, it's once you get rated and reviewed and people read about you, you're in the game. And I knew it was just a matter of time that once those wines got that kind of press, that they would be on the tip of every tongue. And so I embraced and learned everything I could about them.
Speaking of learning, the third thing you say, and I think this is 101, put your chips on talent. You want to make it big. How do you mean?
I grew my family business from $4 million to $15 million in a quick second, 24, 36 months. And I was paying myself $27,000 a year. I had employees making more money than me. And you know, the normal demo of a 26-year-old that maybe did something like that is he's gonna wanna have the car and the place. And I didn't. I wanted to reinvest. You know, too many people don't understand. Sometimes, you know, people are talking about, what are you doing now? To me, it's not about what you're doing now. It's about where you're going. You know, I was a young guy. I'm still a young guy. I want to accomplish crazy things. And there's no way I'm going to cash in. I'm going to reinvest with the people around me. Absolutely. It's hardcore.
And you can't go wrong betting on talent.
No, it's number one.
You want the difference between staying small and getting big. And whatever you do in life, I just want to put this out there in neon again, is it's the people, stupid. You invest in people, will always come back.
And you know what, I'm gonna add one little thing to that. I think you need to invest in people that have a certain DNA. You have to know their DNA. I always like, you know, you always hear people say smarter than you and all that, and that makes a lot of sense. But you are the core, right? You're at the top there, and you need to be able to interact, and more importantly, love the people you're working with to some sort of level. Because once you start creating that family atmosphere, that's Wine Library's biggest secret, that everybody loves each other in my building. And the person that's causing trouble, the one that doesn't understand how to play with the other boys and girls,
they're out.
They're out.
I love it.
They're out.
You talk about spreading your bets around also. Another key thing to making it big.
I'm a very big fan of not playing in the playground that you're supposed to. I'm a wine guy, and I don't go to wine events. I speak at technology conferences. I spoke at Facebook the other day, Google. I want to be in six apart. I want to be in different places that, you know, people are curious about wine. I mean, the people that are into wine, that wine scene, I've got that. I've lived that. That's been my world. I think it's imperative to be involved in the social networks on the internet, to be involved in the real world. All these internet guys love to live just in the internet sometimes. You need to go out there and shake some hand, kiss some babies, live, interact. That's how you can spread it dramatically more.
Okay, and the final one is social equity trumps private equity.
This is my favorite. I honestly can tell you in 2008, not in 2000, maybe not even in 2005, but in 2008 and beyond, I would much rather have a million friends than, I used to say $1 million, I've now changed it to a million friends than $10 million. The social equity, the friendship, what, you know this, word of mouth, how powerful is that?
Most powerful
piece
of communication.
We are now living in a world where every person's word of mouth reaches so many more people. And that, to me, that is the home run of where we are today. Searching, sometimes finding.